This video was brought to you by GeneralPack.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Consider subscribing and supporting through Patreon.com/GeneralPack. This is the mechanism for you to support us financially so we can continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Our corporate sponsor for this topic is AllumiaX.com from Seattle, Washington. Contact them for industrial and commercial power system studies.
Introduction to the Power Factor Part 4A. In the previous part, we looked at some of the equipment and techniques which we can use to improve the power factor of the system. In this part, we will be solving a practical example which we will employ a capacitor for power factor correction. Let's draw a simple example consisting of a generator supplying an inductive load. We will be connecting an ammeter and a wattmeter to measure the amount of real power and current flowing in the system. It is a three-phase system which is running at 480 volts with an operating frequency of 50 hertz instead of the 60 hertz frequency which is common in North America and other parts of the world. Now say that the wattmeter reading shows a real power of 5 kW and the ammeter shows a current reading of 15 amps. We will first calculate the apparent power of the system by multiplying the magnitude of the voltage and current of the system. So the apparent power is calculated at 7.2 kilovolt amperes. The difference between the magnitude of the apparent power and the real power of the power system shows the quality of the power factor, which sufficient to say is less than 1. The greater the difference, the lower the quality of the power factor. If we want to calculate the existing power factor of the system, then we will use the equation established from the previous parts as follows. The power factor is equal to the real power divided by the reactive power, which is equal to 5 kW divided by 7.2 kVA, and that gives us 0.7. So the existing power factor comes out to be 0.7. In order to minimize system losses, a 0.8 or more power factor is generally recommended. So, since we know the apparent power and the real power, we can calculate the reactive power using Pythagoras' theorem, which the reactive power is equal to the square root of the apparent power squared minus the real power squared. Solving the theorem, we get the reactive power of 5.18 kilovars. The final preliminary step before the analysis is to calculate the power factor angle. Next step is to analyze the system, and for that we shall draw the power triangle. In order to find the phase angle between the apparent power and the real power, we will apply trigonometry to evaluate that the phase angle is the cosine inverse of the ratio between the apparent power and the real power. Therefore, we may calculate it as the following. The angle comes out to be approximately 46 degrees, and our objective is to connect a capacitor in parallel with the terminals of the inductive load in order to reduce the phase angle. The first step of our analysis relates to the calculation of the size of the capacitor. Since we know the reactive power, we will need to select the proper size in order to counter its effects of the system. Now to achieve this, we will apply a derivative of a well-known Ohm's law for reactive power, which is as follows. That the reactive power is equal to volts squared over Xc, where Xc is the capacitor reactance required for the power factor correction. Rearranging the subject, we get the following equation. That the Xc is equal to volts squared over reactive power, and that is equal to 480 volts divided by 5.18 kVAR. Plugging in the values and solving for X, we get the result of 44.478 ohms. This is the impedance of the capacitor, which will be required to counteract the effects of the reactive power in the system. Now the final step will involve the calculation of the value of the capacitance. We know that the capacitance is inversely proportional to the angular frequency and the capacitive reactance. Using this relationship, we can derive the following equation, that the Xc is equal to 1 over Wc, which is equal to 1 over 2 times pi times frequency times the capacitance. Plugging in the values of the capacitive reactance and the operating frequency, we get the result of 71.56 microfarads. Using our engineering judgment, plugging in a capacitor with a size of 70 microfarads would drastically improve the power factor and reduce the apparent power, but by what magnitude? And on the other hand, why not opt for a capacitor of the size of 72 microfarads? Let's find out in part 4b. We hope you have a continued interest in this topic and series as a student or professional, and we also hope that you find this content useful and enlightening. Please consider subscribing to generalpack.com and becoming our patron at patreon.com/generalpack. Thank you.